story of the boy who cried, right? The boy watching the sheep on the edge of town grows bored of staring at the sheep, decides to play a joke on the people of his village. He screams to his village, "Wolf! Wolf! There is a wolf attacking the sheep!" The villagers come running, and the boy said to the confused villagers, "Ha! You gullible fools! There is no wolf!" The angry villagers left in a rush to continue on with their work. The next day, the boy grows bored again, decides to test how gullible the people of the village really are. He screams back to the village, "Wolf! Wolf! This time it is real!" The villagers once again come running, and they see no wolf. The boy rolls on the ground and says, "Ha! You were the biggest bunch of fools ever! You fell for the trick again!" The villagers were greatly angered by the boy and left to return to the village. The next day, the boy thought for sure the villagers would not be fooled again and set to think of a new joke to pass the time. By and by, a wolf came along. It snuck up on the flock and quickly killed three sheep before the boy noticed. Scared and fearful, the boy cried out, "Wolf, wolf, help me! There's a wolf killing the sheep!" The boy screamed and cried, but no one came. The villagers had guessed the boy might try again, and they decided after the incident yesterday that if he would cry for help the next day, they would not come. Eventually, the wolf killed the entire flock of sheep, and the boy fled, fearing the wolf would turn its jaws upon him. He reached the village and asked why no one had come. The villagers told him that they did not believe him after yesterday. The villagers said, "You have lied to us twice. Why would we believe you again?" Now, I've always had some doubts about that story, since any mother would come running at the first sign of danger to their little boy. I can say with confidence, my mother would. But the boy was like any child. The boy was someone who craved attention. Standing around watching the sheep grazing was a boring job, but it was a job that was important. The story shouldn't have ended there. Don't lie, it's not immoral. It's something a parent tells a kid, but the kid does it anyway. It should have ended with the boy doing something to make up for the lies that he had told to the village. Something so wonderful and so magnificent that the people of the village would totally forget what he had done and see him for the potential that he has. That is something we all hope for. Attention. I, too, crave attention. Just a couple weeks ago, I caught the game-winning goal for my school's ultimate Frisbee team. I was so happy. It was just like, you know? I tackled a friend on my team, Ben, and we went crazy. I felt like I could do anything. I immediately texted a group of my friends, and I told them I thought I could take two of them on the play, one of which is a really good wrestler, and the other one practices jiu-jitsu. They know I'm not the most athletic person, so it showed them how great I felt. When I got home, I admit, I flaunted my victory. For someone who rarely got a victory, how could I not? It was everything that I had hoped for. It was then that I realized what had come from my hope. If I hadn't gone to the first Frisbee practice with my friend, I would never have made the game-winning catch. If I had never kept coming back to practice, I would never have become best friends with Ben. I never would have been able to say hi to people in the hall without it becoming awkward because I didn't really know them. If I had never gone to the first game, all of this happened because I hoped that I would be recognized. I wanted to do something so totally awesome and amazing that people would cheer my name and they would know my name. I had hoped for this, but so much more had happened. When you hope for something, it's not what you're going to get. You're going to get so much more than that. So much more that what you originally hoped for is small and not enough. That's why you should hope. Because when you hope for something, you don't really know what you're going to get. And who knows? For all the crying and lying and working gets you to a place where you're prepared to hope for something better.